lobby like 30 minutes ago, and that was full of people in their pajamas and blankets, probably spending the night in the lobby and opting to sleep there instead of their hotel rooms. It was that scary.
Yes. And tell us again, how long did it last?
It felt like it was between 30 seconds to a minute before the vibration stopped. In the hotel room. So this is a fairly tall hotel, so maybe it was took a while for the vibration and the swaying to stop.
Are you going to stay in the hotel?
Yeah, I went back to my hotel room priority to sleep it off.
All right, Jay David.
All
right. Well, Jay David, thank you so much for talking with us. We appreciate it. We're glad you're safe. Joining me now on the line is Gonzalo Segundo.
City. Thanks for joining us, Jay. Just describe the moment it hit.
JJ.
3 a.m. here in Mexico City. So I'm staying at the Hyatt Regency in Polanco, Mexico City. It's a fairly tall hotel with over 40 stories, 700 plus rooms. So I was getting ready for bed when the earthquake happened. First, my bed started to shake violently, and I knew right away what was happening. And then the fixtures in my room started to move. The clothes hangers, the light fixtures, even the drinks at the mini bar.
No, just let it be.
And then there was this loud, creaking voice that, the hotel swayed from side to side. It was like the sound of the creaking wood.
Dapat may bayad na to, ha? Like may talent, hindi ka natin ka
siya.
Mama! Stop it! You're blocking the TV!
Why
are you blocking the TV?
But this one in Mexico City was pretty scary. When it was happening, it was definitely my, top five. I went down to the lobby, like 30 minutes.
Kasama ka na daw sila, Tito J.
It's just a lot of people in their pajamas, in black, and I think they're spending the night there instead of their hotel rooms.
There were aftershocks, presumably?
Yeah, there's slight vibrations from time to time. I can still feel it right here in my hotel room right now.
And what are people doing now? How are they responding to this?
A lot of the people are in the lobby, kind of scared. And some of them are leaving. Some of them brought their blankets in and were just hanging out in the hotels, probably sleeping in the couches or at the lobby.
Because obviously, when it hits a city like Mexico City, so much damage is caused, isn't it? By bricks falling and buildings collapsing or falling apart slightly. So when you look out on the street, do you see a lot of damage?
Over here in Polanco, it's pretty normal. Probably just a strong vibration, things moving when it was happening, but not much damage in my part of Mexico City.
And obviously other parts of Mexico hit much harder. Are you hearing any reports from outside the city?
Yeah, I've been monitoring stuff over the internet and news. I know there's some tsunami warnings off the coast. But over here in Mexico City over the past couple hours, it's pretty much okay.
Okay, Jay, thanks for joining us. Our thoughts with you and everyone responding to that and recovering from it as well. Hopefully there won't be any more aftershocks.